Well, here's a video on the CitySports treadmill that I purchased a couple of days ago, and it arrived yesterday. So let's just take a look at this. It now comes with a handle, which is quite useful. It just helps support you in case you're a little bit unsteady when you're running or walking. I think this is designed more for fast walking or very light jogging. On people that are not too heavy, they say it will take up to 100 kilograms, which is a good weight, but I think that's probably pushing it, given the horsepower of the motor. Now this little thing here, it's just a stand or a holder for perhaps an iPad. There's an on-off switch down the bottom, just where that mains lead plugs into. I used it for 30 minutes yesterday and found that the actual belt was slipping to one side. Now that's quite easy to adjust. All you need is the Allen key, which is provided, and on the left and on the opposite side, on the right, there is an adjuster. So just take time, use it for 10 minutes, see how the belt lines up, and then adjust it. Don't tighten it too much, otherwise that might be damaging to the belt. Probably better off by just slackening one side and see if the belt aligns. Now I aligned this morning. I've done 30 minutes fast walking on it, and it's still lined up. So I think I've got it set up quite good. It comes with this little remote controller, which is simply on off and allows you to adjust the speed. After you initiate it, it counts down for 5 seconds and then the belt will start. That's on the lowest speed, as you can see. Reasonably quiet in use. There's a little more vibration, a little more noise when you're actually walking on it. And that's the maximum. Now that's good enough for a reasonable jog. It's got a timer on there, as you can see, and it also measures the distance. When you switch it off, it just runs down slowly until it comes to rest. I'm demonstrating this with a pair of slippers on, which is not the ideal thing. When you're actually walking on this, it pays to keep more towards the front of the tread. So be careful that you don't actually get yourself pushed backwards where you might catch the back of the machine, because the tread length, after all, is not as great as you would find perhaps on a professional machine in a gymnasium. All in all, I think it's pretty good value for money. It seems robust. It's very easy to move around. What you do is drop that handle down and then secure it to the sides of the machine. At the front, you have a pair of rollers so you can actually lift the machine up and stand it vertically where it's supported by the rollers and a couple of, let's see if we can see it, a couple of stoppers. As you can see, the side rubber stoppers either side of the machine, so you can actually stand it in a vertical position out of the way. I think perhaps a government should issue these to every household in the country. Probably might save the NHS, as perhaps people could find time to try and keep themselves fit, particularly in the winter time when weather's not very encouraging for people to get outside. However, they probably would need a machine which is a little more robust than this to take the considerable weight of many of the people that are in this country. But there we are. It's a positive review on this. I'm glad I bought it. If it lasts 12 months, I'll be happy. Certainly was a good workout this morning. I did just over 30 minutes, 2.5 miles, so that's 5 mile an hour. That's a good fast pace, particularly for my age. And I think this would benefit many people. Just one final point. The machine came very well packed indeed. It was in good condition, no marks or scratches on the machine, perfectly brand new. I believe I ordered it Tuesday and it arrived yesterday, Friday. You might just need a hand if you're not too strong. You might need a hand just to set it up. And setting up just means getting it out of the packaging, moving it into a space where you're going to use it, and then assembling the handle, which really takes 10 minutes or so to do.